So basically what happened, we bought this new Stampede Traxxas, okay? Then took it home, ran it for about 2 weeks. The motor, not the motor burned up, but the spur gear stripped out because the motor mounts were loose from the factory. We really never bought a RC car before, so, I mean, not like a RC car of that caliber. So the spur gear was stripped out, went to the guy gave me an 86 tooth spur gear. That spur gear was not the right size, and I think it burned all the motors out. So, yeah, we went through one motor. After I put that spur gear on, the motor burned out. Then we went over to this other place. It's like it was a different place than I bought the Stampede from. It was out of Conyers, and I told the guy I had a Stampede two-wheel drive T550, 12550. I think a 12T550 is the motor. Sold me an 86 tooth. After I put that spur gear on, he went over to his buddy's house and he raced that one. And that night he called me up and said, "Hey man, your son's motor burned up." I'm like, okay, that sucks. So, called Traxxas up, sent me a new motor. Put that motor on. It ran for like maybe, I would say, 5 seconds. He did like a little jump with it, and it went out. And I'm like, you got to be kidding me. This thing's burning the motors out. So, took that motor off. I didn't test it this time. The last time I did test it, I tested from the power in the control box. It was getting power to the motor. The motor was burned out for sure. The second time I did not test it, I basically just said, that's it, I'm sending it off. I sent it off, they sent me another motor. So that's two motors they sent me, two. I put that one on, it didn't work at all. Not one, it didn't drive not one time. So basically, I started thinking like something's wrong. They wouldn't send me a motor that wasn't bad. I'm sure they would have tested it. Something ain't right. There was no power from the ESC. The ESC was burned up. It was getting power to the servo, but it wasn't getting power to the motor. Called Traxxas up again. I'm like, hey man, you know, I'll just be honest with you. You know, I think I've kind of figured it out. The guy sold me 86 tooth. Do you think it's burning the motors up? You know, like possibly, you know, that could over stress the motor, da da da, this and that. And I put like a different tooth gear from the spur gear. I'm not an expert, so I don't know what gear that is that goes on the motor rotor, whatever that arm that sticks out. I don't know what that gear is called, but it was like a 19 tooth, and the one that came on it was a 16 tooth. So that could have had something to do with it. And I told them, I was like, yeah. They said, well, you know, and I told them I took the ESC apart and tried to figure out, you know, maybe there's a loose connection. And they were like, no problem. Just send that back in and we'll give you a new ESC for $25. So I was like, yeah, it's a pretty good deal. These guys are nice. Call them up, nice as can be, you know, try to give you all the information you can ever ask for, anything you want, you know. I went up to the hobby shop where I bought it and then like tried to charge me way more money. And I understand that the hobby shop, you know, has to like, I guess, boost their prices a little bit to make money to stay in business. I did buy the Stampede from them, so don't get me wrong. And I bought drone from that guy. I bought a lot of things. I probably spent about $1,000 in that shop over the years, just buying different stuff. This is the first RC car that I bought. So, you know, I just kind of went with Traxxas. They wanted $25 for the ESC, and I told them, they said, just send the ESC back. I know you opened it up, but we're gonna give you one for $25. I started thinking about it, and my son's friend has a brushless motor, and I asked him how much would it cost for a brushless motor. And I had already went to the hobby shop that I bought the truck from, and he was like, yeah, you can get a brushless motor for $165. called Traxxas up and they were like, yeah, send us it. It's $125 and, you know, we're going to charge you $5 shipping. So $130, you got to send your old ESC in, the one that I already opened up and kind of messed up myself because it was all sealed, waterproof. And, you know, send the old motor. I actually did not send them the broken motor. I sent them the one of the motors that they gave to me that was good. So, you know, I'm being honest. You know, I'm not going to send you the burned up motor. I'll send you the one of the motors that actually you guys shouldn't have sent me because the ESC was bad and not the motor. So I did that. Sent that back. Sent the motor back, the ESC back. And they charged my credit card $130. It took them like 2 days to ship it off after they received it. Charged my credit card $130. Haven't received my credit card statement yet, so I can't really be honest about that. But just got it today. We're gonna do an unboxing. We'll figure this out, hook it up, and we'll see how this thing runs. Stay tuned. This is kind of be a good video because stock Stampede two-wheel drive NIM battery 3000, standard 12T550 Titan 12T550 motor. And we're gonna switch it to a Valenion brushless with a NIM 3000. I haven't upgraded to the LiPo yet because that's another $150. As you guys know, we are into motocross. My son, you know, he met a friend. They like RC trucks. This is cool. There ain't nothing wrong with that. RC trucks are cool. We have enough time to play around a little bit with, you know, toys. But as y'all know, Nathan's about to get into racing. And I told him, I said, I'm signing you up for motocross this year. So get ready. He's like, I'm not ready for racing. I'm like, well, guess what? You're still going to race. So I bought you the KX65. I got his gear. I said, if you lose, that's fine. You can lose. But you're still going to race. So his mom's backing me up. He already plays football. The kid's tough. He's just scared. And, you know, you're going to be scared. You know, you're scared of stuff. But you got to face your fears. You know, the greatest fear of life is death. We all have to face that fear inevitably one day. All right, guys, we finally got it. We got the replacement. The Valenion Extreme Brushless Power System, the VXL3S. ESC and the 3500 motor, brushless motor for the Stampede two-wheel drive. Basically, what happened, the motor went out. Okay, when the motor went out, the reason that I think the motor went out was because when Traxxas had this in the box, they had this motor right here. And this is a replacement motor, but they had this motor, the motor mounts. Take that cover off, because we got to take that cover off anyways, Nathan. What's that? This is Nathan, by the way. He's wearing his brother's futuristic gamer shirt. He has a channel. Check it out if you like games or, you know, whatever kids like, you know, just different stuff. So you go ahead and check it out. But back to the story. Back to the story. He needs help taking this thing off.
Put it on too hard last time.
Here, hold the tire. Put it on too hard. Don't over tighten these. Hopefully I don't strip it out. There you go. So anyways, it came from the factory with this, the motor mounts, very loose. And y'all, it's my recommendation, and I'm sure a lot of pros know this, but check the motor mounts, because that thing came loose from the spur gear. And this is what happened to my spur gear. This is a brand new, this is like 2 weeks old. Look at the spur gear. The teeth are all ate up, and then it just sat there and spun and just ate these teeth up. I filed this one down. So what I did was go to this other hobby shop, and this is what the guy sold me. Look at this. And I told him what I had. This guy's supposed to be a pro. I told him what I had. I had the Stampede two-wheel drive with the T550 motor, brush motor, and he sold me an 86 tooth 48P spur gear. After I put this thing on, that same night the motor burned out, and I'm new to this hobby, so I didn't know what was going on, and it burned out. I called Traxxas up and told them, like, hey, my motor burned out, because I didn't know, you know, this thing right here, you know, was the wrong size. And the reason why I found out is because when they sent me, and Traxxas was nice enough to send me a new motor, and this is actually not the motor right here. This is another motor. This is kind of a long story, but it's a cool story. So listen up. So when they sent me the new motor, we put it on, ran it, and my son jumped the truck after we warmed it up and everything. He jumped the truck off this little step right here. When he did that, it immediately died. Lost power again, and we're like, what in the heck's going on? This motor burned up again. So basically, I called Traxxas and said the motor doesn't work. But the last time I actually checked the motor connections, and I knew that it was getting power from the ESC to the motor with my voltmeter. That second time, remember, I never checked it.
No.
I didn't check it. So the second time, for whatever reason, guess what happened? ESC went out. So I've had this truck for 2 weeks. The motor went out. I thought two motors went out. When I found out that motor actually still worked, the second motor, I called them up because they sent me a new motor. It went out. I called them back and they sent me another motor. So they sent me two free motors. Not free, but I thought they were bad. And I let them know all this. When I tested that new motor, the second motor they sent me, it went out. It didn't work at all from the start. And I'm like, something ain't right. Because we put it in, never worked, not one time. So I ended up checking both the motors, and both the motors actually worked. The ESC, and what I did was just hook the motor straight up to the battery pack. Right here, battery pack. This is a 3000 NIM battery pack. They both ran fine. So there was no power coming out of the ESC, and it was my mistake. So I called Traxxas and told him that, and I wasn't going to say, you know, I was irritated that the ESC went out. I told him about the spur gear and all what happened with the guy selling me the 86 tooth spur gear and all that. And the guy was like, well, I don't know. Another buddy of mine, he said that it might have burned up. And the hobby shop that I bought it from, he was like, yeah, well, that was the problem, the spur gear. So basically, I was like, well, I want to get a new ESC. I have two motors. What can I do? My son wants to basically have more power. So I went to the hobby shop that I bought the truck from. And basically, he said that I can upgrade the ESC, the old ESC, and the old motor to get this Ventolin Extreme Brushless. But he wanted to charge me $165. And I was like, you know, let me call Traxxas just to see what's going on. Basically, you can trade your old motor and you can trade your old ESC in to Traxxas, sending them off, and they will ship you this for $125 plus $5 shipping for $130 total. When they get your stuff, basically they will ship it straight out, charge a credit card, and they'll ship it straight out to your house. So that's what we're doing today. My son's finally... He's actually drove this truck for 2 weeks. He's had it for about a month and a half now, and he's drove it for 2 weeks. And it's been very frustrating. So today we are going to put the Ventolin Extreme Brushless Power System onto his Stampede 2-wheel drive.
And if you put the brushless battery on there, it'll go faster.
You mean the LiPo?
Yeah.
Yeah, well, we have two NIM 3000s, so I'm not going to really do that right now. I got to spend another, you know, probably another $150 on a LiPo system, and I'm not ready to spend that much money. Nathan actually is about to start getting into some motocross racing. You know, he does motocross, so we're going to start doing that. We don't really have a lot of time, but we just wanted to do this on the side. Anyways, this is kind of cool. So stay tuned. We are going to basically take this old motor out. There's the spur gear. There's the, I forget what kind of gear that is. We got to take that off. Take those two mount gears. Those are the two mount gears I was talking about. Take those loose. Take the motor out. And then we'll open this bad boy up. How about you go ahead and open that up right now, Nathan? Here's a little screwdriver. Just pop the tape on that and see what happens. All right, here we go. Let's see what's inside this thing. Ooh. Got a new ESC and a new motor.
What is that?
That's the ESC.
What are all these parts?
I hope it comes with the screws because I don't know where the screws are. I wonder if somebody took the screws off. I'm pretty sure I put the screws back in there. Anyways, I don't see any screws. Uh-oh.
They're probably right there somewhere.
Probably right there somewhere. I hope so.
What is this?
Uh-oh. Is that a new mount? There's a new mount. Yep, that's the new mount. So we gotta take this thing off and put this new mount on anyways. I don't see how it's going to line up. Maybe that's a mount for another truck. I don't know what that's for. Anyways, all right, let's see. What else is in here? Oh, it's another side?
No, I don't know. There's just a little box thing.
Little box. It probably has the hardware in it. Let's see what's inside. It probably has all the screws and stuff. Nice.
Nope.
Not screws. Okay, we got a little 3M for electronics. Anyways, a little sticker thing.
Oh, there's more stuff.
Yep, there's the screws right there. Nice.
There's
comes with a little
stuff.
Allen wrench, screws. All
there's
right, what else we got in that box? So we got the motor. There it is, the brushless baby. Traxxas.
We got some more stickers. See, Daddy?
Oh, nice. You can put those on. Oh, my son wanted to show you. Look at this. It's a new bright cover that he took off one of his other cars, and he's gonna want to. I think he wants to put that on this, so might look cool. In the instructions, it says that the mounting plate has to be. It's sold separately for the Rustler Stampede, Rustler Stampede, and whatever, and Bandit. So. The mounting plate that goes on there lines up just fine. See, there's the two screws, one right there and one on the other side, lines up. I've already started the threads on both sides. It also says that you can put the ESC on with this two-sided ESC tape, which I'll save. That's good to have. This plate is for, I don't know what truck this is for. Anybody that wants to comment about what this comes with, I don't know what that is.
Probably for the Rustler.
Where it comes with, but anyways, so we got to tighten these down. So tighten these down real quick, and it came with the right side. Hold that truck for a second, Nathan, while I'm tightening these down. Tighten these down.
Then why isn't it tightening, Daddy?
It is. See, it is tightening. We're tightening up so we can drive this big old truck.
It's not big, Dad. Trust me, the X-Maxes would beat this. Like, it's like three times the size of this.
It's a little bit loose, but anyways.
Yes, I'm ready.
All right. So I tightened both of these down. The plate that came with it actually works with the Valenion ESC. So now you just got to take this cover off right here, and there's the hookup right there. So Nathan can do that right there.
Oh, how do you do?
Just got to plug that in to where the other hookup was. Just plug and play. Take this. We got to take this motor out right here, right there.
We don't even know.
You got that's a two connector, negative and positive, and this is the negative and positive from the battery. But you got a three prong now. And that should hook right up to the...
We need to charge the batteries.
You got a three prong right here.
We need to charge the batteries.
See, three prong.
And we need to charge the batteries.
And hooks right up, so...
We need to charge the batteries.
You got to charge the batteries?
Yeah.
Why?
Because we can't run them without...
Okay. Well, we'll be back. He forgot that he has both batteries fully charged because he charged both of them
he was excited when he got that other motor, and when he got it, it was the motor didn't work, so that's why we're here. So we got the brushless system. Here it is. We'll be back when everything's put on. We'll see how fast this thing's gonna go. Okay.
22 miles.
All right, guys. This is where we're at. So took the old motor out right here. From right there, I had to take the spur gear off once again because, as you can see, the new Valenion brushless motor came with these two new mounts that are Allen head, which are way better than these, because these right here get stripped out really easy, and they weren't stripped out yet, but they were going to be if you had to keep tightening them up. So on top of that, we took this cover off for the controller, for the servo controller, and we have to hook that up. Ooh, that's magnetized. They sent us a magnetized Allen wrench. It's pretty cool. So we need to have that in. Had to take this spur gear off because this spur gear right here off because this one mount screw for the motor won't come out of it unless you take that off. So I did that. Nathan took this cover loose so we can connect this new connector right here. So you've got to take that off. After that, we had to take this motor off, the Titan 12T550. We had to take this gearing off. This is a 14 tooth. Let's see if we can see it. 14. Anyways, 14 tooth. I'm gonna put that on. We gotta adjust that to the right spot, hook it up. Everything should run. So he's gonna undo that, plug it in, and we'll be back in a second. How are you feeling about it? You think it's gonna run this time?
Probably.
Layla's going to gymnastics. Okay, do a cartwheel.
Okay.
Nice, now do a round off. And do your thing when you do your round off. Yeah. Okay, go. There she goes. A little off topic. That was pretty good. You got a limp at the same time. All right, one more cartwheel and that's it. Go. Nice. Now do your split fast.
A split. Okay.
Look at this. Talk about flexible. That just hurts me just looking. What do you think about that, Bubby? Huh, Bubby?
Hey,
sit.
That right?
Sit. Say hi to everybody at YouTube. Shit, he didn't. Oh, he said it that time.
How do you do it?
All right. Let's see if he did it right.
How do you put that in there?
Oh, you stuck it in without even knowing where to put it. You got to put it. I think you did it right. Did it right. You did it right. Good job. Tell me if you did it right. I think you got two on either side.
Right this way.
All right, guys. And if you did it wrong, then we'll know because it won't run. So, all right, let's put this motor in and hook everything up, and we'll be right back. What I did find out, guys, is that this new VXL3 ESC comes with an extra connector so you can hook up a cooling fan if you're running, like, 3S or, you know, whatever. I don't even have lipos yet, so I'm not worried about that, but it's kind of cool, so you can hook a cooling fan up to it. Anyways, I'm going to leave this open because he hooked this thing up right here. That was already hooked up there. That's for the servo, and this is for the motor, I believe. So anyways, we're going to put this motor on, mount it up. I'm going to try to read up on this to see which way is the best way to mount it, and we'll be back. All right, guys, we got the brushless motor in. Got it lined up over here.
Is it tightening?
He's tightening these new Allen head screws up. I should say motor mounts up. And lined up pretty good. We're going to tighten those up. And then we will... Hold on one second, Nathan. Let me show him real quick. And then we will line that gear up to the spur gear perfectly. And after that, should be able to plug in the connectors to the ESC, make sure the thing steers and powers and it should be ready to run. You excited?
Yep.
See how fast this thing is. It's going to be cool. All right. So he hooked it up. Everything's hooked up on this side. All he has to do is hook these wires up together and we'll test it out. You have your controller?
It's in the bag.
It's in the bag? All right. Well, let's hook these things up, man.
Blue.
They're color-coded, bud. Impossible, unless you're colorblind, to not know how to hook them up.
This?
All right, guys, hooked it up. They were kind of hard to hook up, so I hooked them up myself. Everything's hooked up, good to go. Okay, plug the power. Did you get the remote? You got to have the remote, because if you have the remote, you can test it out. Plug in the battery. Let's see if this thing will run. I'm not going to hook the wheel up or anything like that. I'm not going to waste my time if this thing doesn't even run. So you got to turn the ESC on. The button is in the same spot. That's it. Just press it one time. All right. Let's see what happens. Turn that on. It works.
But it's tight. It's not working.
It's not working?
Nope. It's broken.
Uh-oh. There's a code. Let's turn it off. Some kind of code, I don't know what's going on. Uh-oh. Let's see what's going on. Turn the power off on that, on the controller. We're going to figure this out. All right, guys, so basically what happened was the ESC was set in LiPo mode, which kills the battery. You can't run it at all with the NIM. I already read something about that. It works fine. As you can see, I have it. I don't have it hooked up right now, but I will hook it up in a minute. And I was just saying, I have finished all this right here, the components for the gear. That's the new Allen head, the Allen head screws for the motor mount, and everything's lined up pretty good. We're gonna put this tire back on right here. I'm gonna try to. Look at this, guys. This is like a, it's pretty cool cover. This is just from a new bright car. You know, these covers are like 60, 70 bucks or whatever. This thing right here is bad. I mean, look at it. It's a vet cover. Look at it on this thing. I mean, that would look pretty cool, right, guys? What do you think? I mean, that's badass for a, and it has a wing on the back. So I don't know if that's a functional wing. I mean, with all that air getting underneath the front like that, I'm sure it wouldn't really matter, but I'm going to drill the holes out. We're going to mount it up and see how it looks. Of course, we'll put the, try to cover that new bright up. Try to cover the new bright up and get the holes drilled out, but I think that'll look pretty cool. Just an idea for everybody out there. If you want to find a cheap cover, you can get one of those cheap remote control cars and get the covers off of them. Because this thing right here, I think, where I was at, I had to retape all that because it all broke underneath there. So that kind of sucked. And I used goop with tape, and it's like solid like a rock, and just drill through the tape. I still haven't drilled that side yet. I mean, it's solid baby. So anyways, we'll get back with this. I'm gonna put the wheels on. I'm gonna try to drill those holes out for this cover, for the Corvette cover, and we'll be back and to take this thing for a test run, see how fast it is.
All right, guys,
later.
There you go. I did my Stampede. There's an old motor. Oh my god, look at all these wrenches and stuff. There's an old motor. Put the Lineon S3 motor on there. I got the Corvette mount. It's a little bit off, but I think it's just from Nathan flipping it. I just rigged it up real quick.
All right, how guys, does it look?
Go test drive this thing real quick and see how it does. If you have any questions about what I did, I'm sure you can find it on YouTube anyways, but I'm just going to post this. There's the 86T that guy sold to me. I don't know why he sold that to me. I think that's why my motors were burning up. Oh, I forgot to put the cover on. I need to put that on. Dang. And I didn't put the I put the wheel back on without putting this cover on. Jeez. Anyways, I gotta do that. So I'm gonna do that real quick and then we'll be right back. So later. All right, guys, there it is. The finished product. I put everything together. Let's do a little wrap around of my new. It's funny because it's a new bright, but I mean, come on, guys, that looks pretty dang cool. You gotta admit. He already had that cover. I was like, dude, you could put that on your truck, man. He's like, yeah. So I just drilled out the back a little bit, put those pins in, lined it up just right. I mean, that looks cool. Anyways, okay, let me pick this thing up, and see how it's like angled? I had it angled to the front to give it a little downforce when it's like full speed. So, pick it up just fine. I can pick it up by the back of that fin and it holds it. Let's do a little test real quick. My son went to gymnastics and I hate it because he was very frustrated. Put this one on, the motor went out again, and Nathan was just totally depressed, like, oh God, it's not never gonna work, the truck's never gonna work. And I was like, I'm gonna fix it, just go ahead and go to gymnastics. He's been sick all week. I didn't really want him to go. He hurt his ankle last time. And basically it was the new Valenion S3, and it has the ESC has the lipo mode, so you cannot run a NIM at all in it. It will just shut off. So that's what was wrong with it. So let's go ahead and I fix it all up. I put the top on for him. I wanted him to do it because I want him to learn how to do this stuff. And we'll see how this thing runs. I hated that he left because he thought this thing was never going to run again. But look at this, guys. I just can't steer it because I don't have anybody to film for me. All right, guys, here we are. There it is, the C7R brushless. For some reason, this thing will not go in reverse. I don't know if it's the transmitter. And I don't know. There's no adjustment on the transmitter. So if y'all have any comments about that, let me know. Let's bring it back a little bit, Nathan, so you can drive it off full speed. Let's start it out. Let's do it. All right, here we go. Jesus, kid. I have not done that but one time. Hey, man, you gotta calm down on the turns. You can't just turn it full speed. You gotta slow down. Go slow with it. You can go full speed in a straightaway line.
It's bad.
Okay, drive it. All right, guys, so he's got it. Valenion? Yeah, the Valenion. There it is. Look at that mount he put on it, guys. Bring it over here a little bit, Nate. Look at that. Corvette. He's got the Corvette mount. No reverse for some reason. I don't know why. His controller doesn't have like a forward and back option. So I think that's what it... There is brake. So when you press the reverse, it does stop it. Whoa, look at that. That was cool. Bring it back. All right, guys. So the Valenion S3. With the new Corvette. It's pretty bad to the bone. Bad butt. Anyways. Alright, guys. If you have any comments, just go ahead and put them down in the bottom. And we'll see what y'all say. Let's see how this thing is. Bring it up real quick. Turn around. Look at the side view. There it is, guys. That's a Stampede. All right, film me. I want to drive. Film me now, Nate. Let's see who drives better.
I do. I can do better. I wasn't even driving good. You could have told me, then I would have drove good.
All right, guys, if you have any, what do you guys think about the Corvette body that we put on there? You gotta admit, that looks pretty cool. Pretty cool, look at that dang thing. He finally got his truck back. How do you feel?
Good.
How was your gymnastics class?
Good.
Good?
Yeah.
Nice. All right, guys. There it is. That's with the NIM battery, too. You could put a dual, lipo system on it to get it even faster, but we'd have to have that thing fully aluminumed. Don't run into your sister now. No, turn around. See if you can jump the ramp from all the way over there, if you're good. Here he goes, guys. He's gonna jump this thing. Let's do it. The C7R Corvette Stampede build, Sport Edition. There it is, guys. So you can hear that thing whine. I mean, oh, it whines. Wish I could have somebody to film for me. Anyways, guys, thanks for watching. Please like, comment, and subscribe to my channel. I really appreciate it. And if you want to know anything or need anything from me, just go ahead and ask. Thanks so much for watching. Y'all have a good night. And I'm going to try to figure out how to put reverse on this because obviously it's not working. Or it works fine. Reverse doesn't work.